Hello students, welcome to IBPS Guide YouTube channel. Today we will discuss some fillups for SBI preliminary examination. fillups means that is today our session will be based on triple fillers. Triple fillers means that will be we get one sentence and these one sentence has three gaps and we have to fill these three gaps with appropriate words. to solve this you need some sound vocabularies and specifically the modern words, specifically the word which is used in Hindu articles, the Tribune articles, the Hindustan Times articles, newspaper articles, which is a very common words and which is very famous word. This sentences is based basically this type of words and you need some grammatical terminology. So without wasting our time, let's start our session. At first we have to read the direction and then we start the question. Our first question is direction 1 to 10, fill in the blanks in such a way that the option should fulfill all the three blanks. In the beginning I said to you that is today we will discuss triple fillers. So here is a sentence and this is a one sentence and we get three fillers, three gaps, and we have to fill the options. Our first sentence is the vote dash is about to roll out in the heart of South Bengal, also sanctum sanctorum of the Trinamool Congress support based in Bengal on Monday, marking the start of most dash phase on the dance of democracy in the state. To look at this fifth Bengal seven phase polls as a fight for only seven Lok Sabha's 543 seats would be a gross dash of its importance. The vote dash is about to roll out in the heart of South Bengal as sanctum sanctorum. Sanctum sanctorum means that is a holy place of Trinamool Congress support based in Bengal on Monday, marking the start of the most dash phase on dance of democracy in the state. To look at the 5th Bengal 7 phase polls as a fight for seven of Lok Sabha's 543 seats would be gross dash of its importance. So that is at first we try to understand the theme of the sentence. What is the theme of this sentence? Here the theme is that is a West Bengal passages about talk about polls in Bengal. So in polls in Bengal, and there's a very great significance, great importance. So whether what we choose that must be exclaimed as huge, as extraordinary, this type of words we have to choose. So first option we get juggernaut, second option jeopardize, third option juxtaposition, fourth option judicial, and one option we also get that is none of this. So we have to put the which will be the correct option at first, which can be the correct option. If you take the vote dash is about to roll out in the heart of South Bengal, also sanctum sanctorum of Trinamool Congress support based in Bengal. So first option we get juggernaut. Juggernaut means a huge powerful force. We can say that huge powerful force. Jeopardize means harmful. Juxtaposition means the fact of two things being seen and or placed. Whenever we see that the fact of two things being seen, that is called juxtaposition. So juxtaposition meaning we can write that like this manner, the fact of two things being seen or placed. So and fourth option is judicial. At first try to match the first word. If you write the vote juggernaut is about to roll out in the heart of South Bengal, that's when a huge powerful force is about to roll out in the heart of South Bengal, also sanctum sanctorum of Trinamool Congress support based in Bengal on Monday, marking the start of the most crucial phase of dance of democracy in the state to look at this 5th Bengal 7th phase polls as a fight for only 7 Lok Sabha's 543 seats would be a gross underestimation of its importance. So the Lok Sabha election definitely has some importance, definitely, but nowadays it day by day it is an underestimate of its importance. So first option may be correct, but we run through the second option also. The vote jeopardized is about rollout in the heart of South Bengal. Jeopardized, it will be not jeopardized because this is not any harmful. So therefore, it has some significance. So therefore, jeopardized will not our correct option. And cruddy, C-R-U-D-D-Y, cruddy means there is a worthless or useless, inferior quality. So if we put jeopardized, the vote jeopardized is about to roll out in the heart of South Bengal, also sanctum sanctorum of Trinamool Congress support base in Bengal on Monday, marking the start of the most cruddy phase of dance of democracy in the state to look at this 5th Bengal 7th phase polls as a fight for only 7 Lok Sabha's 453 seats would be gross underwhelming of its importance. So juggernaut, if we put juggernaut, that is meaning the huge and powerful force, and if we put jeopardize, that is a harmful effect. And third option is juxtaposition. Juxtaposition, if we took the vote juxtaposition is about to roll out, that will be absolutely irrelevant word. So most appropriate word can be A, can be B. So we have to look after which will be the correct option, either A or B. Guys, if you take jeopardize, the vote jeopardize is about to roll out in the heart of South Bengal. If it is jeopardize, if it is harmful, it cannot be rolled out in the heart of South Bengal. So whether it is a very big and very powerful force, so that's why it is a rollout in the heart of South Bengal. So therefore, keeping in context to the passage, option A is the best fit, because according to theme we have to put the options. So therefore, according to theme, our answer will be A, that is juggernaut, crucial and underestimation. Let's move to question number 2. In a note accompanying dash, the ICRA said Yes Bank's weak financial result of the fourth quarter and a dash in the credit profile of some of its large borrowers had led to a dash of bank's rating. So weak financial results. So that's mean the meaning of the sentence is definitely in negative point of view. So we have to choose that words according to that, according to theme. First option we get upgrade, second option downgrade, third option downtrodden, fourth option downfall. So guys, I hope it is clear to you. Jo upgrade will not our answer. The note accompanied with the upgrade ICRA said Yes Bank's weak financial result. So if it is upgrade, then financial result cannot be weak. So therefore A will be eliminated option. Second option downgrade, deterioration and reassessment. In a note accompanying the downgrades, ICRA said Yes Bank's weak financial results for the fourth quarter and a deterioration in the credit profile of some of its large borrower had led to a reassessment to bank's rating. Definitely that will be the correct option. But downtrodden and downfall will not the correct option, because disorientation, that is not the correct option for this. And C will also not the correct option, because determination, quarter and the determination of credit profile, no, there will be no any determination. If it is downtrodden, if it is downgraded, definitely it will be deterioration. So it is clear to us, our answer will be B, because downgrades, deterioration and reassessment in a note accompanying the downgrades ICRA, that is ES Bank. So our answer will be downgrades, deterioration and reassessment. Let's move to question number 3. The US-based online giant was earlier in talks to dash a stake in Future Retail, which runs more than 1600 stores across food, grocery and general, and dash after the amended foreign ownership rules that bar e-commerce companies from holding shares and entities selling of their platform. Amazon is now in talks to buy a stake in Future Coupons, a firm owned by Future Group, to ensure that the US retailer is in dash with the new norms. Guys, at first we try to understand the theme of the sentence, theme of this paragraph. The US-based online giant was earlier in talks to dash a stake in Future Retail. Okay, so giant was earlier talks to dash, first option inquire, second option aspire, third option acquire, fourth option acquit. So acquit means to decide that someone is not guilty. Acquit is absolutely eliminated option. Aspire, that is a desire, or inquire, you know, that inquire to want to ask something. So the US based online giant was earlier in talks to acquire a stake in Future Retail, which runs more than 1600 stores across food, grocery and general. Then merchandise, after the amended foreign ownership rules that bar e-commerce companies from holding shares in entities selling on the platform, Amazon is now in talks to buy Future Coupons, a firm owned by Future Group, to ensure that the US retailer is in compliance with new norms. So our answer will be C, definitely, that is acquire, merchandise and compliance. But here we get some new word also, that is compliance. And in B option there is third option is acquire, merchandise and compliance, and in B option aspire, merchandise and commonplace. So which will be the what is the word meaning, thoda sa isko discuss karte hai. First option inquire object and complacent. What do you mean by complacent? If we write that complacent meaning showing a critical satisfaction, showing we can write that showing and critical satisfaction. Second option, markerization, that is a chemical treatment applied on the cotton fabric. This is a chemical treatment applied to cotton fabrics. Yeah, fibers we also can say that. And complacence is not the same meaning as like that, complacent and complacent, that is showing a critical satisfaction. So guys, one thing, this is a very new word and you have to remember that that is a markerization, that is a chemical treatment. So that's why merchandise, that here it is not any markerization, that is a merchandise, because Future Group and Amazon, these all are the base company of merchandise. So therefore our answer is C, that is acquire, merchandise and compliance. Compliance means the action or fact of comply to wish or command. When we take some, just say like that, we can say that the action or fact of complying with wish or command, that is called compliance. So our answer will be C, that is acquire, merchandise and compliance. Next question, question number 4. With season figures that could send any opponents into a dash, Andre Russell, an all-rounder from West Indies, was looked up to for some dash on the field, but the fact that he was out on the first ball and overall poor performance in the middle order dash our fate. Which can be the correct option? With season figures that could send any opponent into the dash, Andre Russell, an all-rounder from West Indies, and was looked up to for some dash on the field, but the fact that he was out on first ball and overall poor performance in the middle order dash our fate. First option, whirlwind, and second, that is blitzkrieg and sealed. that is blitzkrieg, that is a very blitzkrieg means that is a intense campaigning, intense military campaigning, if we write that. So that's a meaning of a blitzkrieg, that is an intense military campaigning. Okay, so which will be the correct option? Which with season figures that could send any opponent into a, if we write that, whirlwind Andre Russell all-rounder from West Indies was looked up to for some blitzkrieg, that is intense campaigning on the field, but the fact that he was out of the first ball and overall poor performance in the middle order dash of our fate, that is a sealed our fate, may be correct. But B option, we also have that, that is a worthwhile. Definitely worthwhile will be not the correct option, because Andre Russell, we see that all-rounder from West Indies was looked up to and some, there is a lot of hopes, but fact to yehi tha, that is he was out of first ball. So it will be not the worthwhile. And if we take word, blitz, second option is blitz, may be correct, but third option will not correct. There is not the smeared. So therefore, C will be not the correct option. And fourth equally is not the correct option. So according to keeping in the meaning of the context of the option, A is the best fit. Because the passage talks about the player's innings, and therefore option A, when put in the blanks, bring out the meaning of the passage. Because this is a meaning, this is a player's innings. How the innings of Andre Russell was. So that's why whirlwind, blitzkrieg and sealed. Our answer will be A. That is whirlwind, blitzkrieg and sealed. Question number fifth. Last year, the state colleges had made it dash for universities and colleges to conduct all admissions online to prevent interference from students' union and stop dash of money from the candidates. Several colleges which did not have the dash to conduct the entire process of online admission were caught unawares, causing difficulties for applicants. So which can be the correct option? First option, we get mandate extracting investment. Second option, mandatorily extract and inferred. Third option, mandate extortion and infrastructure. So which can be the correct option? Fourth option, we also get that mandatory extraction and infrastructure. Mandatory is extraction and infrastructure. So let's match. Last year, the state college has made it. If we say mandate, made it mandate for university and college to conduct all admissions online to prevent interference from students' union and stop extortion of money from the candidates. Several colleges which did not have the dash infrastructure to conduct the entire process of online admission were caught unaware, causing difficulties for applicants. So if we take C option, that is C option will be correct option, because extortion mean the crime of getting money. This is the crime of getting money. So therefore, extortion, mandate, extortion and infrastructure will be the correct option. So our answer will be C. Because most important thing, other option do not make any sense when placed in the blank. So that's why C will be the correct option. That is mandate, extortion and infrastructure. Let's move to question number 6. The cyclone has dash fish supply from Malancha and other South 24 Parganas as well, leaving a dash gap between demand and supply. A fish vendor in the local market said that the prices of some fish have risen up 150 per kilo, mainly due to demand and supply dash. So the cyclone has, first option unaffected, second option ruptured, fourth option, third option agreement, and fourth option is herination. So which can be the correct option? The cyclone has unaffected to fish supply. definitely it will be not the correct option. Unaffected is not the correct option. But if we take the cyclone has ruptured the fish supply from Malanche and other areas of South 24 Parganas as well, leaving a yawning. Yawning means very large or wide open, widely open, which thing. Yawning gap between demand and supply. A fish vendor of local market said that the price of some fish has been risen up on 440 per kilo, mainly due to demand and supply mismatch. So guys, I hope it is clear to you. Our answer will be B, that is ruptured, yawning and mismatched. So answer will be B, because the others options are absolutely not appropriate. So therefore ruptured, yawning and mismatch. Let's move to question number 7. The Dash Indian Education Award, which is given nationally to outstanding schools and their heads for making education socially dash, was awarded to the Union Chapel School. The school has been dash the cause of inclusive education. Which can be the correct option? The Dash Indian Education Award, which is given nationally to outstanding schools and their heads for making education socially dash, was awarded to the Union Chapel School. The school has been dashed to cause the inclusive education. So first option is abjured. Abjured means avoid, that is avoid. Second word is abjudicated. Abjudicated means that is to make an official decision. We can write like this manner, to make an official decision. Third option है coveted, that is coveted to want very much able to become strong. That is a, we can say that to want very much. Something we have some want, that is called covet. To want very much. We can write that is to want very much. Very much. And here also the word that is profess. Profess means to say something. To say or declared. And again D option is coveted, relevant and professing. So the if we write abjured, avoid of Indian Education Award, that is not the correct option. If we take that the abjudicated, that is an official decision, it is also not the correct option, because adjudicated, that is not the correct option here. But if we take the want very much, the coveted Indian Education Award, which is given nationally to outstanding schools and their heads for making education socially relevant and was awarded to the Indian Chapel School. The school has been professed to cause the inclusive education. So professing definitely has been professing, because that is present perfect continuous tense, has been professing the cause of inclusive education. So the correct option will be D, that is coveted, relevant and professing. Let's move to question number 8. By dash his image and making him look small, these people wanted to form an unstable and weak government in the country. This triggered dash among the workers and the leaders. It insulted the dash of a good and righteous man. So which can be the correct option? By dash his image, definitely brightening his image, if we take that is a making him look small, the people wanted to from unstable. If his image is brightening, so definitely it will be not the unstable. But if we take the by tarnishing his image, making him look small, these people wanted to form an unstable and weak government in the country, and these triggered outrage among the workers and leaders, and it insulted the martyrdom of a good righteous man. But in our second option, that is a recantation means to publicly say whether you can do or not, whether you have some belief or not. When we say publicly, that is called recantation. So recantation is not the correct option here. That's why the perfect fit of this passage is option B, because it brings out the sense of the passage and grammatically correct options also. So by tarnishing his image and making him look small, these people wanted to form an unstable and weak government in the country, and these triggered among the workers and leaders, and it insulted the martyrdom of a good and righteous man. So therefore our answer will be B, that is tarnishing and outrage. Guys, one thing, my dear students, just you try to understand the theme of the sentence. Theme of this sentence. Don't put your own word and don't put in your own idea also. Just you have to go through the theme of this sentence, because this all word will be put according to context of the passage. Don't try to put your own opinion. According to passage, which word will be applicable, that is your answer. Okay, let's move to question number 9. The biggest dash students face during their drop year in a dip in motivation, the lack of school routine, the absence of family support or sufficient guidance may lead to students dash off. In some cases, they may even become gloomy and depressed, and it is important to dash your own persistent and resolutions. So the biggest dash students face, which can be the correct option? The biggest problem, definitely, that must be the problem. The biggest problem students face during the drop year in a dip in motivation, the lack of school routine, the absence of family support or sufficient guidance may lead to students dash off, and in some cases they may have become gloomy and depressed, and it is important to dash your own persistence. So if we write blockage, the biggest blockage students face, it will be not the correct option. But if we take the biggest bridge block students face during their drop year in a dip in motivation, the lack of school routine and absence of family support and sufficient guidance may lead to students slaying off, and some cases they may be even become glooming and depressed, and it is important to evaluation your own persistence and resolutions. And third option, the biggest roadblock students face during their drop year in a deep motivation. Guys, here roadblock means jo road ko block karna, this is not thinking here, because if we think that the biggest roadblock the students face during the drop year, if they drop their year, they think that the way of their life becomes block. The biggest roadblock students face during their drop year in a deep in motivation, the lack of school routines, absence of family support or sufficient guidance may lead to students slacking. Slacking means not busy, procrastinator, slacking, and in some cases they may become gloomy and depressed. It is important to evaluate your own persistence and resolutions. So bridge block, maybe you think that bridge block is not the correct option, but bridge block will not the correct option, it will be road block. But its road means the life, the path of their life. So in that point of view we use here road block. So our answer will be C, that is road block, slacking and evaluate. Slacking means that is not busy, slow. And the next word is, that is a slamming. Slamming means that is a heavy blow. We can say that that is a heavy blow. Heavy blow or impact. So the correct option will be roadblock, slacking and evaluate. Let's move to question number 10. The dash participated in the dash proceedings for 2 days and record her statement, but on the third day she opted out and complained that she was denied assistance to advocate before the dash. So which can be the correct option? The dash participated in the dash proceedings for 2 days and recorded her statement, but on third day she opted out and complained that she was denied assistance of advocate before the dash. First option, complaint. Second option, complainant. Third option, again complaint. Fourth option, again complainant. But inquiry and enquiry, these are the options. So inquiry and inquiry, we have to look at that whether which will be the correct option. So what is the meaning of complainant? Complaint, you know that complaint means shikayat karna. But if we take the complainant, complainant means a person who makes a formal charge of court by saying someone, just like a legal action. That is a legal action. The complainant, there is a legal action against legal action we take against someone. And complaint, you know that what is the meaning of complaint. And complainant, so whether we take complaint, it will be not the applicable. The complaint participated, that is not the option. So if we take the complainant, that is a either B or D option. So if we take the complainant, then the in the inquiry proceeding. Okay, if the complainant participated in the inquiry proceedings for 2 days and recorded her statement, but on the third day she opted out and complained that she was denied assistance. She was denied assistance of advocate before the panel. So that's why our answer will be panel, matlab I mean to say D. D option will be the correct option because it will be not the inquiry. It is not inquiry, we need inquiry because here is a proceedings and it is a participated and they record the statement. So therefore it will be inquiry. So that's why correct option will be D. So these are some 10 fill in the blanks, fill ups, which is absolutely based the context of the passage and theme of the passage. So I repeat again and again, at first, my dear students, try to understand the meaning of the sentence, what is the essence of the sentence, and then you put accordingly. Otherwise, your thinking and the theme of the sentence, if it is different, so your sentence must be wrong. So be very careful. Take your time, take 1 or 2 minutes time to solve the question and read that question thoroughly, read the sentence thoroughly, try to understand the theme and then put the words. And most important thing, just you need practice. Practice makes a man perfect. So keep practice on. And on next class, again I will come to you and take some different type of questions for SBI PO examination. Till then, goodbye. Have a nice day.